In this video, I will explain about this error that called some light are casting shadow when no mesh is receiving shadow. I'm going to the adjustment window and I will move on to the lighting category. By clicking on the directional light, it can be seen that the cast shadow option is on for this lighting. This means that this lighting casts a shadow. But there is something more we need to do so that we can see the result in the viewer. I will open the meshes category. I will choose one mesh, for example, and turn on the receive shadow option. I will perform the same operation for the other existing meshes in the model. And click on save scene. After we have turned on this option for all the meshes, we can see the effect obtained on the model in the viewer. Let's see how it looks like without shadow and with shadow. This is off and this is on. The effect of the shadow will be stronger as the lighting intensity. I return to the main page. A second option for the above arrow is to press on the try to fix button. This automatic repair that the system performs is the opposite of what we demonstrated earlier. It does not turn on the receive shadow option for each of the meshes. Rather, it turns off the cast shadow option for all lighting. We can see it here on the directional light. You can choose between these two options. We recommend turning on the receive and cast shadow to get better result of the final model. If you have chosen to keep the shadow, you may encounter a situation where you will see these stripes on the model, these artifacts. This happens because there is not enough resolution for the shadow. You can make an adjustment like in the lighting, I'm going to choose the light source. And on shadow size, I can increase the resolution to 1K. It did not completely remove the stripes. What else can be done is to play with the normal bias values and raise it a bit in order to get rid of them. You can do the same thing for all the light sources that cast shadow.